Hi everybody, it's Casey Williams. Well, it seems like Chrysler's been sticking the supercharged V8, the Hellcat engine, in just about everything. But there's one obvious place where it hasn't been yet, and that's in the Ram. Well, that's until now. The vehicle we have today is a 2021 Ram TRX. It's not only the most capable off-road Ram, but it's also the fastest. Well, the TRX looks like somebody really pissed it off. I mean, look at the front of it. You got the big nostrils up in front, the LEDs in here, the big black grille, tow hooks down below. It just looks mean and menacing. It looks like the kind of truck that would have a supercharged V8 behind the grill. Really like the way it looks. Everything's just blacked out, looks super, super cool. Come around to the side. Underneath of the wheel wells, those are 18-inch wheels. It's hard to believe there's a great big truck, but they're 18-inch wheels. But they look really good with their Goodyear Wrangler off-road tires, exactly the wheels you need to get off. Look a little closer, you can see the fenders have been extended a little bit. They bulge out to make sure they can handle those big wheels. And they do some really smart things too. They look good, but also very functional. Like the step bar. It helps you get in and out, but it doesn't hang down. It's not gonna get hung up on logs and mud and stuff when you're off-roading. It just stays right there and just looks great. Of course, you have the crew cab. Nice long doors, easy getting in and out of the back of it. Lots of room in the back. But coming around the back, some other nice features. Step down below, that'll fit into place. You can get into the bed easily. You got tow hooks, preset up for the trailering, all the electrical connections there. And looking in the bed, of course, it's the spray-in bed liner, but the spare tires already in the bed. You know, you're on a trail, and it's mud or sand, you don't have to climb underneath the truck if you get a flat tire. Already in the bed, jack it up, change the tire, and be on your way. Well, as befitting a truck that's pushing almost $100,000 in price, the interior is really set up for luxury. And it really just starts with the details. You know, the stitched dash coverings, the stitch here on the console, real carbon fiber, suede. I like the thick leather-wrapped steering wheel. You got suede on it as well, flat-bottom steering wheel, carbon fiber. You know, the nice thick leather seats are heated and cooled in front, heated in the back, steering wheel's heated. Really all the nice luxuries you'd want. And it goes beyond just the way it looks and feels to actual content. You got the dual-pane sunroof, the Harman Kardon audio system, wireless charging, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto connections. Very easy to get everything connected here, Bluetooth, of course. So that works out really well. But I think what people really noticed in the Ram is the tablet-sized touchscreen. It's been up for a couple of years, but it really looks good and it works really well. I think Chrysler already had some of the best infotainment systems available, and this is really the best of the best. Easy to use icons, going for media here. This is for the driver's seat. Seat, steering wheel, all that, one screen, you get to that. Your apps, phone, I don't have mine connected, otherwise I'd show you. Climate controls. And then for all the camera systems. So pretty easy to use those. Also auxiliary real buttons up above for the main controls. So you can change the temperature for both sides here, fan controls, and defrosters here. Also proper volume and tuning knob, which I always really appreciate in vehicles. Because sometimes you're sitting in traffic and you just kind of want to scroll through the stations without having to go in and touch it and program it. So I just think Chrysler just does a very nice job with this. Down below, trailer brake controller, all built into the dash already. Your USBs are down here, nice thick cup holders. Also, like, you know, they always have really, really deep console storage. Lower, upper. And here, again, you know, a lot more storage here in the dashboard. Upper glove box, lower glove box. Plenty of space for everything. And this vehicle also comes with a ton of safety systems on it. So there are also, you know, systems to keep you both safe and moving depending on the conditions. Of course, there's launch control. It wouldn't be a Hellcat-powered vehicle without launch control to get you cleanly off the line. All of your four-wheel drive controls are right here in this little pod. Also, change the modes for the powertrain, you know, for mud, for snow, for rocks. There's even a Baja mode, so it configures the powertrain and the way the vehicle behaves, depending on the conditions for that. It also has a full suite of safety systems to keep you safe on the road. You've got forward collision alert system with pedestrian and cycle detection, lane keep assist, blind spot warning, rear cross path detection. Pretty much everything you need to keep the fenders painted and to keep everybody safe inside. Well, of course, what makes the Ram special is that 6.2-liter supercharged V8. It delivers 702 horsepower and 650 pound-feet of torque, routes it to the four-wheel drive system through an 8-speed automatic transmission. You can just step on the throttle and you just hear the supercharger howl in the front, you hear the exhaust boom in the back, and it is just an absolutely demonic sound that just makes you happy. I just love driving the truck. You know, fuel economy, you know, it's 10 miles per gallon in the city, 14 miles per gallon on the highway. I never saw fuel economy like that because I was just enjoying it way too much. But that's why you have a truck like this. If you can afford the truck, you can afford the gas to go in it, and you sure should enjoy it. But beyond that, you know, this truck is really capable off-road. It is jacked up, you've got the off-road tires on it, you can configure the powertrain, it's got the adaptive suspension system, so you can really go crawl over rocks and really do some serious off-roading. On city streets and on pavement, you just kind of stomp down the bumps as much as go over them. It's just really great. But again, that adaptive suspension, it also keeps you pretty stable, you know, when you're going through corners. You realize you're driving a big top-heavy truck, but it's good. And when you really get into that throttle, you're looking at 0-60 in about 4.5 seconds, which I think is fantastic. If you want to, you can still hook a trailer up to it, and you can tow 8,100 pounds. So you've got a truck that can still work like a real truck, but on those weekends, or just when you're on the freeway driving to work and you just want to have a little fun, just step on it, hear that supercharger whine, and just feel it accelerate. It's absolute joy. I don't know if the Ram really needed a Hellcat engine, but I am sure glad that they decided to put one inside of it. I mean, you already had, in the TRX, the most capable off-road vehicle you could probably get from Chrysler, outside of perhaps a Jeep Rubicon. But then you put the big, powerful, supercharged V8 in it, and it just becomes this whole other truck. And let's be clear, trucks like this are not going to be around very long. Tesla's Cybertruck will likely outrun it when it comes out in the next year. But for now, to have all that power, just the screaming of the supercharger and the rumbling exhaust and the big wheels, it's all just an absolute joy. So the TRX starts just under $70,000. Ours, fully equipped, is at $91,205. It's a lot of truck and a lot of money, but if you can afford it, I think you'll really enjoy it. Well, next week we'll have another fun car. Till then, storm forward.